after a win in their season opener on the road at Motor City. For the first time in franchise history, the Prowlers welcome the Motor City Rockers to McMorran Place for their home opener. Good evening, everyone. I'm Will Wiggleman here at McMorran Place for the Prowlers' home opener as they take on their in-state rivals, the Motor City Rockers. The Prowlers defeated the Rockers yesterday at Big Boy Arena by a final score of 3-2 behind two goals from Joe Devaney and the game winner late from Dalton Jay. Danik Rodriguez picked up his first career win, making 40 saves, including a couple of 10 bell stops, especially one late in the game on Derek Makima after Jay scored that goal to give the Prowlers back the lead. So the Prowlers looking for another big effort tonight in front of the McMorran Place crowd for the very first time this season, and we'll have it live for you in just a few minutes. You're watching Port Huron Prowlers Hockey on the Prowlers YouTube channel.
Adventures await you at the award-winning DoubleTree by Hilton Port Huron. Experience the breathtaking view of sailboats and freighters framed against the background of the impressive Bluewater Bridge, all from the comfort of your elegant guest room balcony. Planning a wedding? The DoubleTree by Hilton has the perfect setting to celebrate a marriage with its wonderful landscaping and beautiful reception area. So whether it's a romantic getaway, a family vacation, or a company outing, sweeten it with a view to remember at the DoubleTree by Hilton, Port Huron.
Back here at McMorran Place as the Prowlers set to head out of the locker room and onto the ice for the first time this season. Real quick though, let's give you the lineup for the Prowlers this evening. Same lines as yesterday, save for Caleb Williams coming in as the extra forward for Sam Gagnon. And yesterday, Matt Graham started his third line of Weber, Ulmer, and Federley. Today, it's the first line. Joe Devaney, Evan Foley, and Larry Vartiainen, the starters up front for the Prowlers. Alex Johnson and Gino Minnie, the starters on defense. And in goal, Richard Shipman, number 72 for the Prowlers, was here last season and now getting his first shot in 2022-23. And let's take a look at the goaltending matchup as we see the Rockers come out onto the ice. It's going to be mentioned Richard Shipman last season, 6-8-1. With a 4.16 goals against average and an .891 save percentage here with the Prowlers. And on the other side, it's Trevor Babin. And Babin coming in after yesterday making 34 stops in the loss, an even 3.00 goals against average and a .919 save percentage. Let's give you the rest of the Motor City starters while we're here. Up front, it's going to be Everett Thompson, Brendan McKenzie making his Rockers debut, and Jonathan Giuliano also making his Rockers debut. They're the starters up front. On defense, Mike Wynn and Brandon Contrato. And in goal, again, it's Trevor Babin. And now the Prowlers just about set to exit their locker room. We'll take you down to ice level for that.
Alana, Alexis, Ashlyn, Jen, Maddie, Paige, Paisha, Sarah, and Serenity. The Prowler Spirit is coached by Amanda, and the CL Spirit Director is Christine. Brothers fans, are you ready? It's time to meet your 2022-23 Port Huron Brothers. At forward, number 15, Dakota. Number 18,
Huron native Alex Shire on the national anthem. He'll be doing a set between periods, between the first and second period. We will bring that to you when he does that. But first, we have 20 minutes of hockey, our opening 20 minutes here at McMorran Place. Thank you for joining us for Friday afternoon hockey here in Port Huron. Prowlers wearing their brand new gold alternate jerseys, recently unveiled on social media. If you haven't seen that, you can get a better look at them if you check the Prowlers social media at PH Prowlers on Instagram and Twitter and on the Port Huron Prowlers Facebook page. Richard Shipman lining up in the goal to our right. Trevor Babin lining up in the goal to our left. We already mentioned Babin playing his second night in a row. Made 34 saves yesterday in the loss. And Matt Graham starting his strongest line yesterday. Devaney, Foley, and Vartiainen. Joe Devaney, of course, the first two goals of that game. One in the first, one in the second. And the second one off of a nice backdoor pass from Larry Vartiainen from left wing to right wing. An easy tap-in for Joe Devaney. And that's how you have to beat a guy like Trevor Babin. He's going to make all the saves he's supposed to make, but you're going to have to beat him backdoor and make it tough for him. So the McMorran crowd all set to go here. And we are underway from McMorran Place in the Port Huron Prowlers home opener. Everett Thompson trying to get the first chance going for Motor City, but it's knocked down by Johnson, and Gino Mini lifts it out of play, and the first souvenir of the season at McMorran Place comes just 17 seconds in. A good crowd here in McMorran Place, still people filtering in as a face-off coming in the Prowlers defensive zone. Tied up, and Mini works on the left wing boards. Double team there. And now Gio Mini with a second opportunity to get the puck out. Bounces off the right wing boards at center. Coming back the other way with speed. And a slap shot by Giuliano over top the net. Wrap back around to the right wing. Devaney with some space, and he'll skate it. Joe Devaney tried to get towards Vartiainen, but a couple of rockers in the way. It's taken by Makima. Turned over. Here's Devaney, but he couldn't control the rolling puck. Back to the point, Mini. Wraps around for Devaney. Vartiainen working back to the point. He'll curl back down low. Larry Vartiainen flips it towards Devaney in the corner. Foley goes in to help get that loose puck. And we're going to have our first penalty of the game called a minute eight in. It is a cross-checking penalty, and it goes against Derek Makima. Makima scored the tying goal yesterday, second for the Rockers in a 35-second span. after Brad Reeder scored the first goal in franchise history, but it's the first power play opportunity for the Prowlers this season. Jay works it back to the point. Now Johnson on the near half wall. Down low Graham. Versus down low for Jay. All the way back to the point to Johnson. He's with Ulmer, gives it to him. Johnson, center point, steps up, shoots, and glove save by Trevor Babin. So it's Vartiainen, Graham, Jay, Ulmer, and Johnson, the top power play unit for the Prowlers this evening. We are 14 seconds into the power play. Referees discussing something with the off-ice officials. And they're going to take a couple seconds off this clock. I did notice that they got that started just a little bit late. Rockers wanted to make sure that it was exactly 2 minutes and no more. Face-off won by Graham. Here's Ulmer. Johnson on the near side. To the corner, one-touch pass! And Vartiainen's one-timer blocked a little bit painfully by Colton. Turn around, clearing attempt by Reeder, stopped just at the line by Ulmer. Down low, in front, Graham! And Babin got the toe on it. Sefferdini, around his own net, sends it all the way down. Minute 12 to go on the man advantage. Prowlers making some changes. Out come Merritt, Devaney, Foley, and Federley. Alex Johnson, the lone holdover from the first power play unit, sends it in front. Merritt pushed it just wide. Alex Johnson first on it in the corner. In front, Devaney couldn't control it again. Puck loose and poked away. Now Rocker's going to try to come up the other way. Sent in on Shipman, and he'll hold on. Frank Schumacher coming off the bench to complete the change. That's the Prowlers' second power play unit tonight. 46 seconds to go on the penalty to Derek Makima. 17:39 left in the first period. Shots are 2-1 Prowlers. One back and Federley slows things down. Sauce over to Schumacher. He'll start out. Up to Foley as he enters the zone. Merritt, one hand poke to Devaney behind the net. Quickly out to Schumacher. Shoots high. And Babin got the glove up to make the save. Trevor Babin, a right-handed catching glove over in that goal to our left. And he has a very good glove hand. Tough to beat on that side. Rockers making some changes. Clouston and Rotondi coming out on defense. They join Gaudette and the man with the puck right now. That's Brad Reeder, scored the first goal in Rockers franchise history yesterday. Lifted high and out, 15 to go on the penalty. Federley working out from his own end. D to Schumacher. He gets the red over the blue, but forgot the puck. Final seconds tick off, and we're back to five-a-side hockey as Devaney sends it in on Babin. He'll hold on for an offensive zone faceoff for the Prowlers. They send out Weber and Caleb Williams. Dakota Ulmer staying out, so Williams filling in on that third line after Federley came off as a part of that second power play unit. Hainzel and Parsons, the defense pair, and that faceoff win splits them. Hainzel first on it. Curls up to Caleb Williams, making his season debut. Gaudette turning up ice. Here's Contrado. Soft dump in. Glove down by Parsons. He gave it away. Quick shot save by Shipman. Turnaround shot by Cardinal. Didn't get all the way through. Looked like it hit Hainzel. And now Reeder backs out to center. Forced back in by Wynn. Rockers defenseman first on the forecheck. And now he'll back out. Austin Weber tried a drop pass. Gave it away to Everett Thompson. Thompson around the net. Back up top, Wynn. Wrist shot saved by Shipman. It was deflected on the way through. Parsons takes his man into the boards. Rockers still the puck. Sharp angle try. Goes all the way through the crease. Wynn just did keep it in. So the attack can continue for Motor City. Finally, Parsons able to force it out with some help. Brought right back in. Sauce pass towards the net, didn't get there. Puck loose in the crease and clear it out. That was Suffredini trying to go across to Brendan McKenzie, making his Rockers debut today. Bartlett tried to send it back to the point. He took a big hit from Merritt as he did. Puck skitters back into the Rockers end. 15-15 to go in period number one. Graham deflected that pass, but still gets to Bartlett. One touch up to Makima. Quick shot saved by Shipman, and he'll hold on. Sixth shot of the game for the Rockers. So the Prowlers power play 0 for 1 tonight was 0 for 3 yesterday. That's something they want to improve on, dead last in the FPHL last year on the power play. And the special teams battle, oh so important in this league. Minnie forced it up the right wing boards. Jay lifted Bartlett's stick. Shot from the point, knocked down by Johnson. And Jay didn't get out quick enough. And the Prowlers are offside. 14:52 to go in period number one. We'll take a quick timeout. You're watching Port Huron Prowlers Hockey on the Prowlers YouTube page. Back here at Big Boy, or at McMoran Place, excuse me, just over 5 minutes in, Prowlers and Rockers tied at none so far. Prowlers already 0 for 1 on the power play. They send out Merritt, Jay, and Matt Graham at center with Johnson and Minnie on the back end. Graham to draw with Reeder. Face off won by the Rockers. Graham takes the puck away at center. Minnie trying to force it back up the boards. Now Merritt, trying to speed in. Suffredini got a stick on that. Puck hops out of play. And it looks like an offensive zone faceoff coming for the Prowlers. Graham and Reeder slide into the faceoff dot once more. Tied up, and Merritt takes it. Gives it back to May at the point. Wrist shot, save! Comes back over to the near side. Johnson poked away from him by Cardinal. Tommy Cardinal almost had a breakaway. Say he gets a sharp angle shot that Richard Shipman turns aside as the first Let's Go Prowlers chant of the year gets started here. 3-on-2, but the pass hits Colton Skate and the Rockers come back the other way. Gaudette all by himself. Minnie takes the body. Johnson takes the puck. Jay knocks that pass down, takes the shot. Blocked it aside by Babin. Vartiainen couldn't handle the loose puck, so it's poked back out to center. Heading D-to-D to Schumacher. Flipped up, icing on, waved off as Devaney got there first, but the Rockers didn't agree. That's Clouston, thought he beat him. Battle on the boards, worked back to heading at the point. His shot missed wide. Schumacher, good pinch to keep puck in. Devaney gloves it down. In the corner, Foley in front, didn't get to Vartiainen. Larry sends it back down towards Foley, tried to push it back out in front. That puck was bouncing. So Devaney back to Schumacher, D-to-D, heading to the slot towards Vartiainen. Turnaround try, blocked. Rockers trying to come away with numbers. Would have had a 3-on-2. They decided to change. Come in front, and they score. Everett Thompson slips one through Shipman's five-hole, and the Rockers are on the board first. It's 1-0. It was going to be a 3-on-2, but Brendan McKenzie changed, and that didn't matter for Everett Thompson. Good power move on Dustin Heading. And that one just slipped through Shipman's legs. With 13:09 to go in the first period, the Motor City Rockers have their first lead in franchise history. And they have the first goal at McMoran Place this season. Ulmer wins the faceoff cleanly back to Parsons. So the Prowlers looking for a quick answer. Backhanded into the zone, hops over Contrado's stick, Federally in on in the corner. Ulmer tried to feed in front towards Weber, bounced over him. Shot didn't get through. Now behind the net, Lambden, taken in by Weber. Support comes for the Rockers, and they get it out. Bartlett on the 3-on-2. Gives it to Contrado, but couldn't find the down low pass to Lambden. Meanwhile, away from the play, Hainsel took Bartlett in after he made that pass, and Bartlett unhappy with that. And now Bartlett gets knocked down by Parsons in front, and Brian Parsons is going to be the one to get a penalty, although Bartlett did take out Hainsel in the corner. Hainsel made the hit after Bartlett made the pass. Bartlett, not a fan of that. Put a hit on Hainsel in the corner, then went to the front of the net. Parsons took him down. And the only penalty goes to Brian Parsons. So with 12:31 to go in the first period, a two-minute penalty for Parsons. And the first look at the Motor City power play tonight. 1-for-8 last night. First goal of the game for them was a power play goal. And the man who scored it lining up for the faceoff, Brad Reeder, going up against Matt Graham. False start, Reeder giving a shot towards Graham. Finally they drop the puck, and Reeder first on it. Jay tried to poke it around this man, couldn't, so Rockers keep the pressure on. Colton trying to wrap it around, Gaudette. Hassled by Johnson in the corner, kicks it to Cardinal. Tommy Cardinal, sharp angle try, didn't hit anything. Comes back to Colton at right point. To Gaudette, kick save by Shipman. Mini takes in Gaudette. Jay gets the puck out to center. And now Gaudette tags up, so the Rockers right back in. Quick shot by Suffredine, deflected, saved by Shipman. Mini around his own net. He'll wrist it all the way down. Minute 16 to go on the penalty to Brian Parsons. Foley challenges Makima. Gets around, but Henning able to clear it back to center. Halfway through this Parsons penalty. Colton. Up to Makima as he enters the zone. Tries down low, and Colton couldn't get a stick on it. Now set back in front, that hit Henning, and turned around all the way down the ice by Evan Foley. Started back up by Suffredini, former Prowler. Split his first season in the professional leagues here last year. Also played in the SPHL with Vermilion County. Team that's having a little bit of trouble right now with arena situations. Pulling up is Rotondi. Johnson forcing it out, trying to continue forward. Alex Johnson fights his way into the Rockers' end. Final seconds ticking off the Parsons penalty. And the Prowlers 1-for-1 on the kill tonight. Rotondi gets it deep. Work back in front. Oh, and a weird hop put the puck right in front of the net. The Rockers unable to get a good try off. Federle knocks that pass down. Backhand shot, save, rebound. Another one from Trevor Babin. Back to the point. Mini, a quick shot. It's loose, and that one just didn't cross the line. Clouston knocked it off the goal line. Down low, Ulmer back in front. Mini thought about lining it up. Instead, gives it to Weber. Back to Parsons at the point. That shot hit a stick. And finally backhanded out by Elias Thompson. But Vaughn Clouston saved a goal. It hit Babin, slipped behind him, bounced in the crease. He had no idea where it was. And Vaughn Clouston dove to keep that puck from crossing the line. Here's Foley. Turnaround shot. He scores! Evan Foley from a weird angle ties this one up with 9:32 to go in the first. So all that pressure from the Prowlers, all starting from that shot from the point that got through Babin and Clouston cleared off the line. It's Evan Foley from below the faceoff dot and right about at the half wall who beats Babin to the far side. And it's a one-all game, the first goal for the Prowlers here at McMorran Place in 22-23. Landon turned over to Devaney, but he turns it right back over. Now Foley steals and gets it in deep. Babin straight to Contrato. He lifts it high all the way down. And that one is going to go for an icing. So it's Evan Foley from Larry Vartiai, and the first goal for the Prowlers at home this season. We'll take a quick timeout. You're watching Port Huron Prowlers Hockey on the Prowlers YouTube page. Will Wiggleman back here at McMorran Place in Port Huron, Michigan. Prowlers and Rockers tied at one with 9:05 to go in the first. Everett Thompson and Evan Foley, your goal scorers so far. What's been an entertaining first period. Shots 10-9 in favor of Motor City. Schumacher rims it around deep. Bartlett and Henning chasing it. Dustin Henning gets there first, keeps it deep. Jay wheeled it in front, nobody home. Bartlett, back to the point, there's Henning a shot. Missed it wide, Jay tried to get a tip on it, couldn't get a touch. Graham to Merritt, tried to give to Schumacher, couldn't do it. Sam Merritt recollects the puck, comes in with speed, drops back to Graham. Mac Graham, back to Schumacher, back door, and Merritt tried the deflection, just missed. That one came on net, Babin was low, and he made the save. Bartlett had it knocked away by Schumacher. D to Henning, it's the Prowlers regroup, and they'll start a change. Henning in deep, and it looks like he didn't get the red line, so icing is called against Port Huron with 8:12 to go in period number one. Reeder and Ulmer to take the draw. Prowlers in the midst of a line change, so Dakota Ulmer out there with Jay and Merritt. The two wingers due to change as we have a delayed penalty coming up against Port Huron. Oh no, against Motor City. A slashing call coming up against Tommy Cardinal. Prowlers will go back to the power play for the second time tonight. They send out, looks to be mostly the second unit here. It's going to be the second unit for the Prowlers. Foley, Devaney, Merritt, Schumacher, and Federley. Face-off one back to Federley. Over to Devaney on the right half wall. Works down behind the net to Foley. Tried to force it in front. Puck bouncing around. Reeder gets to it in the left wing corner and clears all the way down. Fairly to start back up, spins it to Schumacher, and he enters the zone. Frank Schumacher dropped for Foley, tried to give it to Federley, and instead Gaudette took it away. Here's Gaudette, pass into the slot. Reeder got a little bit on it. Shipman made the save, but certainly Joe Devaney coming back made that shot a lot harder than the Rockers wanted it to be. But Richard Shipman up to the task on the short-handed chance for the Rockers. New power play unit for the Prowlers. First group back out there. They'll be going up against Lamden Makima Clouston, who has the puck now. And Rotondi, who dumps it all the way down on Shipman. 1:10 to go on the penalty to Cardinal. Drop back to Johnson. He gives to Jay, curling, starting to move up ice. Dalton Jay trying to take it himself, drops to Graham. Prowler set up in the offensive end. Bartian touches it back to Johnson. DDD to Ulmer. Back to Johnson, nobody in front of the net. Graham down low to Jay. Finds Ulmer, shoots! Saved by Babin. Cade Lambden turned away from pressure, got it out all the way down. Vartiainen tried to knock it down, but only got a piece. 25 seconds to go on the Prowlers' power play. Johnson to Vartiainen. He dances in, curls back, and gets it deep. Graham first on it, wrapped around towards Devaney. Back down low to Graham. One touch to Parsons at the point. Devaney winds, fires. And that one deflected high and wide. And the power play expires. Prowlers 0 for 2 as Bartlett knocks down that pass. He'll get it himself. Ross Bartlett tried to set it in front, but his team was changing. So Hainsel first on it. Adam Hainsel waiting. Now he starts to go. Gives to Parsons. Off the boards. That gets into the Rockers' end. Wynn trying to work it out. Gives to Cardinal. Fresh out of the sin bin. And worked back to Contrado in the Rockers' end. 5:35 to go in period number one of a 1-1 game. Gaudette being worked over by Hainsel. Adam Hainsel took the puck momentarily. And now the Prowlers able to exit the zone. Foley to Devaney, 2-on-2 rush. Devaney tried to push it down low, deflected to the corner. Devaney in front, loose! And coming in was Caleb Williams, but Babin held the post. Hainsel in a race with Reeder for the puck, and Adam Hainsel wins that one, stops up, and he'll find some time and space. Williams out there with Ulmer and Weber, as once again Austin Federley coming off that power play opportunity. He'll take a break, and Caleb Williams moves in. Here's Ulmer, gives to Williams, back to Ulmer, slid it through the goal mouth. Back the other way come the Rockers. Everett Thompson looking across, looking for the pass. Instead goes high, and Shipman knocked it down. Shot blocked by Williams. Second try from Colton. Gobbled up by Richard Shipman, and we'll take a timeout. 4:22 to go in the first period here at McMoran Place. You're watching Port Huron Prowlers Hockey on the Prowlers YouTube page. Back here at McMoran Place, 4:22 to go in the first period. Shots 13-11 in favor of the Motor City Rockers. Both Babin and Shipman making a couple of good saves so far in this one. Face off deep in the Prowlers' end, and we'll do it again. That comes right to Shipman. He covers up. Graham and Makima lining up for it. Face off one cleanly by Makima. Shot to the point from the point, deflected down, and Shipman covers up again. And we'll have another face off to Richard Shipman's left. Seeing his first action this season. Played his rookie year last year here in Port Huron after 4 years at Stony Brook University. Here's Colton. D to D to Suffredini. Voids a hit from Graham. Couldn't avoid that hit from Dalton J. Prowler, or Rocker sent it all the way down. Icing waved off. Here comes Henning. Henning moving up. Puck stays in. Merritt tried to slip it down low. Couldn't do it. Sam Merritt taking in hard. Meanwhile, puck rimmed around and all the way back into Prowler's territory. Frank Schumacher is the Prowler's change. Sends up to Devaney fresh off the bench. Joe Devaney tried to shoot. It was blocked. Puck loose. No one knew where it was. Vartiainen one-hands it back deep. Reeder tries to start the breakout on the right wing side. Looking up for a teammate. He'll drop back instead. Gaudette tried to take the puck off the boards. Couldn't. And now Foley's into the zone. Tried to backhand towards Vartiainen. Knocked away. Johnson trying to keep it in at left point. But couldn't do it. Here come the Rockers. Quick shot saved by Shipman as Rotondi got one on the rush. Mini out from behind his own net. Up to Devaney at center. He'll send it in on Babin, who blockers it into the corner. Everett Thompson all the way across and batted in by Giuliano, but out of play with 2:33 to go in the first period. Federley back with his line for this faceoff. Ulmer and Weber out there with him. Here comes to Austin Federley. He's going to slow up, wait for help, enters the zone, tried to find Weber streaking towards the net. Couldn't do it. Ulmer back to the point to Parsons. Walks the line, fires, saved by Babin. A couple Prowlers go crashing into the corner. And whistles blow. And we'll see what's going on here. Maybe an offsides call here as faceoff just outside the Rockers zone. Contrado off of Hansel's glove. Here's Makima on the backhand. Shipman got down to make the save. Everett tried to put it back in front. Puck ends up on the back of the net, and the referees blow it dead. Exactly 2 minutes to go in the first period of a 1-1 hockey game. Round two of the Battle of I-94 between the Prowlers and Rockers. They'll play again tomorrow here at McMorran Place. Same start time, 7:05. Quick shot. Nobody saw that one through. Missed everything. Now Ulmer stepping around his man, but couldn't get it out of the zone. Landon one hands it deep. Bartlett to Makima. He couldn't get a handle on it. Parsons backhands it out of the zone. Wynn turns back, tries to enter. Has a man going to net. It's Cardinal, got it there, but Tommy Cardinal couldn't direct it on goal. Contrado back at the point. Effectively dumped it back into the left wing corner. Ulmer taken in behind the net. Now Dakota Ulmer escapes with the puck. Gives to Jay and he'll slow things down. Long pass up to Federley, deflected in to the Rockers zone as we approach the final minute of play. Graham with a steal, Jay in front. Oh, what a save by Trevor Babin coming out to rob Dalton Jay. A grade A scoring chance for Dalton Jay on the turnover, but Trevor Babin up to the task as he makes his 13th save of the period. Suffredini off the glass and to the line and out. Rockers could have had a 2-on-1, but McKenzie couldn't control that bouncing puck. Schumacher taken away by Giuliano. Grant puts a hit on Giuliano. He turns and fires towards the net. Now McKenzie behind Cage. Put it in front. Knocked away by Graham. And we have a penalty coming against the Prowlers. It's a tripping call. And it looks like it's going against Frank Schumacher. So Schumacher heads to the penalty box for the second time this season. Got a cross-checking penalty yesterday. And the Rockers to the power play for the third time today. Face-off won back by Motor City. And they set up. Gaudette couldn't handle that pass. And a free clear for the Prowlers. 28 seconds left on the clock in the first period as the Rockers come in offside. This is actually the second power play for the Rockers tonight. 0 for 1 so far. Work back to Johnson. He'll send it all the way in, just past Babin. Rockers trying to get one last rush going as we have 15 seconds left in the first period. Sent deep behind the Prowler's net. Gaudette on it, working with Mini, two biggest players on the ice. Battle it out. Clouston tried a quick pass across. Reeder couldn't get it. Final seconds tick off. And through one period of play, we have a 1-1 score between the Port Huron Prowlers and the Motor City Rockers here at McMorran Place. Evan Foley, the goal scorer for the Prowlers, and Everett Thompson, the goal scorer for the Motor City Rockers. Shots on goal, 18-14 in favor of Motor City. Coming up during this intermission, we have Port Huron's own Alex Shire doing a set of his own music. We'll have that for you in just a few minutes. But first, gear up for the new season at the Prowlers' official team store. Located on the north end of McMorran Arena, the store is open every home game all season long, featuring t-shirts, sweatshirts, hats, koozies, and more. Rep your team in style with gear from the Prowlers' team store. 1-1 our score. We'll be right back. You're watching Port Huron Prowlers Hockey on the Prowlers' YouTube page.
Thank you.
And now to do a set of his own music, Port Huron's own Alex Shire.
How y'all doing? This song's called Running in the Cold. Thank you.
That's Port Huron's own Alex Shire. We'll be right back in just a few minutes with some analysis from that first period. You're watching Port Huron Prowlers Hockey on the Prowlers YouTube page.
Yeah.
back here at McMorran Place. First intermission underway as the Prowlers and Rockers knotted at one after the first period. Motor City holding an 18-14 shots advantage. Both teams 0-2 on the power play in that first period. First goal of the game belonged to Everett Thompson for Motor City as he came in on the rush. Good power move to the net and slipped a backhander between Richard Chipman's legs to open the scoring, 6:51 into the first. But just past the halfway point, Evan Foley, after a ton of pressure from the Prowlers, took a turnaround shot from below the dot and about on the half wall that just beat Trevor Babin to the far side, seemed to fool him just a little bit. And that tied the score right back up, and that's where we sit. Heading into this second period, the Rockers will have a minute 21 of penalty time after Frank Schumacher's tripping minor with under a minute to go in the first period. And that's where we stand right now as the Prowlers and Rockers just a few minutes away from coming back out for second period action. We'll be right back. You're watching Port Huron Prowlers Hockey on the Prowlers YouTube page.
Adventures await you at the award-winning DoubleTree by Hilton Port Huron. Experience the breathtaking view of sailboats and freighters framed against the background of the impressive Bluewater Bridge, all from the comfort of your elegant guest room balcony. Planning a wedding? The DoubleTree by Hilton has the perfect setting to celebrate a marriage with its wonderful landscaping and beautiful reception area. So whether it's a romantic getaway, a family vacation, or a company outing, sweeten it with a view to remember at the DoubleTree by Hilton, Port Huron.
teams returning to the ice for our second period action. Prowlers will begin shorthanded. Frank Schumacher still a minute 21 to serve in the penalty box. Richard Shipman and Trevor Babin switching ends. Shipman will now be on our left. Babin sliding into the goal crease on our right. Both made some very good saves in that first period. Both gave up just a single goal in that first period. And we'll see what both of them can do here in the second. Looks like the Prowlers are going to start Graham and Jay up front on the penalty kill. Looks like Johnson and Minnie coming out to begin the PK on defense. Meanwhile, Bartlett, Wynn, Makima, and Gaudette out there along with Contrato, the power play unit, to begin the second period for the Motor City Rockers. Final 10 seconds coming off the clock, and as we get set to play here in the second period, both teams about set to get ready to go. Although it looks like we're going to have to reset the clock, as the clock has been running and the penalty clock went down to a minute 3. It's supposed to be at a minute 21. We've reset the game clock to 20 minutes, but still have to work on that penalty clock now. And that's what they'll work on in the penalty boxes right now. A decent crowd here for opening night. Lots of fans in their seats, but still plenty of fans standing above the goal that Trevor Babin now occupies. Right in front of the Prowlers team store over by the Chuck-a-Puck table. And of course, you have people in those new suites over on our left. Brand new for this season. 7 suites up on the south end of McMoran Place. Freshly built. And I see more than a couple of them are being occupied here tonight. Still working on getting that penalty clock fixed. And it's still at a minute 3. Both teams, I'm sure, anxious to get things back underway. Don't want to stand around too long. We've worked back up to a minute 8. Let's see if we can get a little bit more. We need 13 more seconds. We've got 5. We need 13 more. Both teams still waiting around as the score clock. Oh, we're up to a minute 32. That's 11 seconds too many. Need to lose 11 seconds. And they might just leave it here at a minute 32 and let Schumacher out at 11 seconds, and that's exactly what they're going to do. No more delay. And we are set to drop that puck. Graham wins it cleanly back to Minnie, and Johnson tried to set it all the way down off of Wynn's foot. Jay finishes the job, gets it behind the Rockers' net. Worked around towards Contrato. He takes a hit from Jay. Graham in the corner to support, but couldn't get the puck. Worked up to Makima, surrounded by Prowlers. He'll circle behind the net. Bartlett taps it to Wynn. Back to Ross Bartlett in the corner. Knocked down by Johnson, still has the puck. Taking some wax from Alex Johnson. Now Johnson puts him on the ice. Gino Mini lost the puck. Johnson battling behind the net with Makima. Wynn takes the shot, blocked by Johnson. Mini fanned on the clearing attempt. So the Rockers continuing the pressure with 40 seconds left on the penalty. Contrato a shot, deflected wide. Shipman might have gotten a piece of that. Graham and Gaudette in the corner. Graham went down. Now Gaudette tumbles down, ripped towards the off the side of the goal, and finally cleared all the way down with 20 seconds to go on the penalty to Schumacher. Rockers enter the zone, pass down low towards Reeder didn't work, and sent back down by Parsons. That should take care of the rest of that penalty time. As Schumacher up, set to come out of the box, and we are back to five-a-side play. Hainsel collects in his own corner, sends it up the right wing side. Didn't have a forward there, but now Foley challenging, trying to get it out of the end, out of his own end. Everett Thompson muscles off Parsons and gives it to the point. Backhander towards the net. Thompson couldn't get a stick on it. Now Merritt trying to move the other way with speed. Cardinal back. Suffredini joining him off the bench. Sam Merritt's shot blocked partially, but Merritt on it first, taken into the wall by Colton. Rockers take the puck. Suffredini gloves it down. Took a hit, and now Merritt with a hit behind the net. Lifted high out to neutral ice. Parsons settles things down. 2.5 minutes into the second period, Prowlers have already killed off a penalty here in the second, well, most of one, as Federle enters the zone and it avoids a hit from McKenzie. Again, that weird hop off the Zamboni door affected that puck as it was rimmed around. It didn't cause any trouble for the Rockers, almost caused trouble for the Prowlers in that first period. Giuliano backhands it out of his own end. Schumacher first on it. Tried to send it up, hit the referee. Now the Rockers with a chance, and Shipman comes up with a big pad stop. Back to the point, Colton a drive. Shipman steers it to the corner. Schumacher taps it out of the zone. It's going to go all the way down for an icing. 3:15 into period number two. Still a 1-1 score between the Rockers and Prowlers. Makima and Ulmer on the draw. Schumacher takes it off the faceoff, but Bartlett keeps it in. Schumacher chased by Bartlett. Ross Bartlett throws the body. Schumacher comes back at him. Puck finds its way to Weber. He gets it to Ulmer. 2-on-2 rush with Federle. Ulmer takes the shot, save, puts it back on net, hit the side of the goal. And now the Rockers able to get back out to center. Ulmer comes all the way back to recollect. Dakota Ulmer with speed. Gives to Weber. Now Federle takes the shot, partially blocked away. Sent down behind the Motor City cage as the Prowlers complete a forward change. Foley line coming out for Port Huron. Here's Vartiainen, steps around his man, has some help. Larry scores! Larry Vartiainen picks the top corner on the rush, and the Prowlers have their first lead of the night. It's 2-1. And what looked like an innocent enough shot, as Vartiainen had options going to the net, ends up fooling Babin. It might have gone off the stick of the defenseman that was guarding Vartiainen. He went down to try and block a potential pass. That shot just fooled Trevor Babin. Picks the top corner over his glove. The Prowlers have the lead. Vartiainen first on the puck. Tried to get to the middle. Foley couldn't tap it home. Johnson and Wynn battling in the corner. Now a two-a-side scrum. Johnson keeps it deep off that Zamboni door. Stays behind the Rocker net. Everett Thompson tried to chop it out. Finally, the Rockers get it out, but only momentarily. It's now Minnie trying to work the other way. Gino Minnie into the zone himself, tried to give to Graham. Couldn't connect. Thompson and Johnson race for it. Everett Thompson sends it to the middle, but Joe Devaney, the only one there. He'll safely clear the zone. Devaney tried to dangle his way in, couldn't do it. Delayed offsides, and now Prowler's touch up. The Rockers able to get it out. Reeder couldn't step past Graham, and now Dalton Jay has some space. Jay working in, but Colton with a good defensive play to take it off his stick. Parsons gets it in deep. Merritt behind the net. Jay gives it back to him. Sam Merritt tried to send it to the front. Now gives to Jay, turns and fires. That one deflected wide off a stick. Hainsel pitches to keep it deep. Contrado tries the other way. He's able to get it out. Rockers not looking to make a change right now as Parsons sends it up. Say Ulmer touched it, so icing waved off. Merritt to the middle. Jay trying to one-touch to Ulmer on the back door. We couldn't find him. Now Parsons has it chipped by him by Giuliano. Giuliano taken down. Play continues. Hainsel, slap pass up to Jay. Curls back into his own end. Now up to Merritt. Touches it into the Rockers' end. Long pass up to Cardinal. He gets it to Gaudette, but a good play by Austin Federle to lift the big man's stick. Suffredini taken in by Weber. Makima trying to find the puck in his skates. Federle gets it as far as the line, and Suffredini gets it the rest of the way out. 3-on-2 if the Prowlers can control it. Here's Federle down low, back to Federle, but he couldn't complete the give and go. Prowlers offsides. Federle didn't know as he attacked the puck. 2-1 Prowlers, and we'll take a quick timeout. 13:35 to go in the second period. You're watching Port Huron Prowlers Hockey on the Prowlers YouTube page. .35 to go in the second period here at McMoran Place. Larry Vartiainen's first of the year has the Prowlers up 2-1 over the Motor City Rockers. Motor City still out shooting Port Huron 21-16 here in the second period. Clock started prematurely. So we'll have another stoppage for a clock for some clock management. And it looks like they're just going to hold the clock for a few seconds. Face off down, and Henning curls away from Bartlett. Now gets up to Foley. Evan Foley, high shot. Babin knocks it down and covers. This line for the Prowlers has been one of their better lines. I'd say their best so far in about a game and game and almost a half so far into this season. Vartiainen, Devaney, and Foley have done some damage. They've scored all but one of the Prowlers' 5 goals so far this season. And here's Bartlett behind the defense, but he's offside. A break for the Prowlers as Ross Bartlett split Henning and Schumacher on the Prowlers' blue line and took that headman pass. But just a bit too quick to turn and go into the zone. The puck comes all the way back into the Rockers' end for the faceoff. Devaney keeps it deep. Suffredini curls it back towards Everett Thompson. Knocked down at the Prowlers' line. Thompson going to try again. He'll skate it this time. Curls back, looks for a pass. Colton towards the net. Vartiainen got down to block it, and then he blocked that next attempt standing up. Colton dropped back to the point, but that's his position, so nobody there. Suffredini turning on Devaney. Colton, headman feed to Everett Thompson. Two Thompsons on this Motor City team, Everett and Elias, no relation. As puck cleared back to Motor City ice. Graham, Jay, and Merritt stepping back on to the sheet for the Prowlers. Johnson watching Clausen, and he comes in. Backhand try, stopped by Shipman, and then he gets shot from the point. Prowlers could have a two-on-one if they hurry. Merritt has Jay going to the net, trying to get it to him, and a penalty coming on the back check. Shipman heading to the bench. Now Graham just missed everything on that shot as he got a nice pass in front from Sam Merritt. Prowlers will slow things down with the extra attacker on the delayed penalty. Federally give to Merritt as he comes into the zone. Merritt, a rising shot, missed the net. Johnson puts it back around behind the net. Graham, and finally touched up by Vaughn Clouston, and we'll get the call. A hooking penalty coming against the Rockers, and we'll see the Prowlers power play for the third time. They're 0-2 tonight. Goes against Vaughn Clouston, who got his stick in the midsection of Dalton Jay, coming back on the back check, trying to keep Jay from receiving a nice saucer pass from Sam Barrett on the rush. So the Prowlers sending out that top unit that we've mentioned. And winning the faceoff is Merritt. Schumacher all the way around, off the Zamboni door, and right to win, he clears. Federally up to Schumacher, he enters the zone with speed and slows up as the Prowlers set up. That pass hopped over Foley's stick, but Schumacher backed him up. Quick shot towards the net, missed. Devaney kept it in. Joe Devaney works down the wall, behind the net towards Foley. Merritt came in to support. Couldn't get enough on that. Now Wynn backhands it out of the zone. Tough couple of looks here for that power play unit as the Prowlers switch things up. Federally, the lone man left from that unit. Drops off to Jay. Dalton Jay in. And Babbitt made the blocker save. Graham leaves it for Jay. And now Dalton Jay in the right wing corner. Back to the point to Ulmer. Now Johnson with 45 left on the penalty. And Colton one-hands it out. Ulmer tried to send it across towards Johnson, blocked by Cardinal. He's going to skate back into his own end and then put it back into Prowler territory. Came back up, but Cardinal tried to put it back in. Ulmer blocked it. 20 seconds left on the Prowler power play. They can't seem to get much going. That one sent all the way back down. That should take care of the final 10 seconds. Ulmer to Johnson. Alex Johnson with some speed, looking for a pass, drops off to Ulmer. All the way around towards Johnson. We're back to 5-on-5. They hit Clausen out of the box. Ulmer, the one man back, he's a forward. Gets over to Thompson. Johnson on the way back, got a stick on that shot. Shot from the point, blocked by Weber. Second try, didn't get all the way through either. That looked like it hit Johnson, who was battling in front with Bartlett. Now Caleb Williams over to Ulmer, and he'll send into the zone. Finally, Dakota Ulmer can get off, and the Prowlers can get two defensemen out there. That second defenseman is Adam Hainzel. He gloves it into the Rockers' end. Here comes Clouston. Sends up to Thompson. Everett Thompson tried to dance his way by. Hainzel kept him to the outside. Thompson still with the puck. Now loses it. Here comes Caleb Williams. rimmed around the boards and hit that Zamboni door once again and pop back out. Talk about a consistent odd bounce. It's that Zamboni door over on the north end of the arena. Gaudette battles off Parsons, takes a big hit from Heinzel, and the pass in front. Makima couldn't beat Shipman. Sent up towards Makima. Parsons met him there at the red line. Icing waved off. Foley takes it. Heinzel knocked his man down behind the net. And now Foley and Vartiainen, 2-on-2 into the zone. Vartiainen just stayed onside, but Foley fanned on the shot. Devaney surrounded by rockers. And Motor City takes the puck back. Giuliano backhands it only as far as Schumacher as he knocks it down with the glove. Tipped in on Babin. That took a weird hop. Hop right in front of Trevor Babin, but he's able to keep that in front of him and keep playing moving. 7:15 to go in the second period. Prowler still holding on to a 2-1 lead. Henning, backhand try, gets in on Babin, and he'll cover up with Sam Merritt bearing down on him. Hey, 7:06 to go, period number two. We'll take a quick timeout. You're watching Port Huron Prowlers Hockey on the Prowlers YouTube page. Back here at McMoran Place, Prowlers holding a 2-1 lead over the Motor City Rockers. Shots 22-20 in favor of Motor City. 7:06 to go in period number two as we line up for a faceoff to Trevor Babin's left. One by the Prowlers, heading D-to-D to Schumacher, puts it on net, loose in front. Babin made a big save on Mac Graham, who almost found Twine on the loose puck in front. Heading off the boards, back out to center. Suffredini trying to get it back deep, and he does. Schumacher there for the Prowlers. Gives over to the captain, Heading. Long pass up towards Merritt, out of his reach. And icing is called. Merritt takes a run at Colton just after the whistle. The referee's not going to let anything else transpire out of that after the rough game we had yesterday. Both teams getting into a couple of fights, a lot of roughing penalties, and a lot of stuff after the game. Off the draw, shot towards the net, knocked down. Shipman directs it toward the corner, put back on net, didn't get all the way there. Johnson couldn't get through Bartlett. Shipman will cover up. We'll have another faceoff. Ulmer's line coming out for Port Huron, but he loses the faceoff, and Suffredini gets it down deep. Bartlett tried to wrap it in front, couldn't do it. Comes back to Suffredini, just puts it back into the left wing corner. Pushed out as far as the line by Johnson, kept in by the Rockers. And it looks like they're calling a hand pass against the Prowlers. So faceoff upcoming. I think many thought that he knocked that down with his stick. Referees disagree, thought it was his glove. So I have another faceoff. One to the corner. And Johnson works around to the left wing side. Federle tried to keep it away from Contrao. It squirted to the middle, but Austin Weber there to clean it up. Federle into the zone, avoids a check. Gets it down deep. Ulmer in front to Federle. Couldn't get a clean shot away. And sent all the way back down to Prowler ice. And icing is called. Line up to Babin's left. Ulmer, Weber, and Federle still out there for the Prowlers. One back to Minnie, quick shot. And good save by Babin. Ulmer getting into a little shoving match with one of the Rockers. That's Brendan McKenzie. And now McKenzie has his arm wrapped around Weber, and they're going to go. Weber throwing punches at McKenzie. McKenzie down to knee, he's back up and down. McKenzie goes down, and Weber still throwing punches as McKenzie was down on his back. And Austin Weber's got his first fight of the year. First fight here at McMoran, and the fans are loving it. McKenzie had a bit of a shoving match with Ulmer after the whistle. Referees looked like they were directing him to his bench and said he got his arm wrapped around Weber. And Austin Weber was more than happy to take on that challenge. Got a few good shots in there on Brendan McKenzie. Five each for fighting as we get another faceoff in the Rockers zone. Caleb Williams coming out to replace Weber on this line for the Prowlers. 4th into the corner. And the Rockers on there first. Clouston gets it to Cardinal. Goes off the boards and out. Johnson brings it right back in. Shot blocked. Federle backhand towards the net. Babin was down to get it. Ulmer back to the point. Mini DDD to Johnson. Wrist shot towards the net. Blocked down. Everett Thompson sees that one deflected out of play. Just about 5 minutes to go here in period number two. Prowlers holding on to their 2-1 lead against the Motor City Rockers. Both teams making changes as the Foley line coming out for the Prowlers, the Makima line for the Motor City Rockers. That one tipped back into the Prowlers bench again. And we'll do it. We'll have another face-off in the Rockers' end. Prowlers out shooting the Rockers 9-4 in this second period and now have the shots lead in the game 23-22. Referee didn't like how that was dropped, unless looks like we're going to get a timeout. 4:56 to go in the second period. Prowlers with a 2-1 lead. You're watching Port Huron Prowlers Hockey on the Prowlers YouTube page. Back here at McMoran Place, 2-1 Prowlers as we're under 5 minutes to go in the second period. Foley works it in front. Now Devaney on the backhand. Didn't get all the way through. This line trying to start a cycle. Vartiainen got hit from behind. They're going to call that one. And a battle ensues behind the net. Larry Vartiainen slow to his feet. Devaney has a guy wrapped up. Evan Foley battling with his man. That's Rotondi. Rotondi 6'1", Evan Foley just 5'10". So a bit of a tough battle there for Evan Foley, but he was up for it. It's going to be Makima heading to the box. Going to be 2 minutes for boarding. Let's see if hit Larry Vartiainen on the numbers. Vartiainen back on the Prowlers bench. And they're going to do this face-off outside of the Rockers zone. Prowlers have six on the ice right now. Somebody's going to have to get off. And Henning gets off. The referees didn't notice, but Dustin Henning noticed that they had too many players on the ice. That would have been interesting to see if there would have been a penalty come from that, because the referees are supposed to make sure that there's the right number of players on each side before they drop the puck. But either way, here's Joe Devaney sending it towards the net, trying to find Foley on the back door. That was knocked away. Now Bartlett trying to race ahead. Devaney took him down, took the puck away. And now Foley trying to get into the zone, but sent back down by Rotondi. So they actually give Makima a 2 minute cross checking penalty. Either or, same difference, 2 minutes in the box. Merritt tried to walk the line before he got into the zone and drew his teammates offsides. So a minute 13 to go in the Prowlers power play. 0 for 3 so far tonight. Vartiainen back on the ice, and he chips it to Johnson, who rims it all the way around into the Rockers' end. And it's cleared all the way down. That might have hit the linesman standing in front of the Prowlers' bench, which is why Dakota Ulmer wasn't able to control it. Here's Jay into the zone, takes the shot, save, rebound, back on net, off of a Rocker. Now Vartiainen a shot, and Badman got back to make the save. Graham tried to keep the pressure on, but Vartiainen couldn't hold the line. Larry has it poked off his stick. The Prowlers will have to do a full breakout. Quickly up towards Johnson. Alex Johnson taken away by Bartlett. Vartiainen took it off his stick. Now Contrado into the zone. Contrado tried to put it across to Bartlett. That puck was in the air. And a 3-on-2 for the Prowlers if they hurry. Jay to the middle. Takes the shot off of Babin. Jay has it again in the corner. Tried to rip it to Ulmer sneaking in for the point, but it was cut off. Prowler still on it. Ulmer, a one-timer from the slot, couldn't get it to go. He'll take it again. He scores! Dakota Ulmer, second time's the charm. And the Prowlers have a 3-1 lead. It's their first power play goal of the season. So Babin got the one-time shot, but Dakota Ulmer took the rebound, settled it down, and picked his corner. And he gets his first of the year. It's a two-goal lead for the Prowlers. That's the lead they had at the end of the second period yesterday in Motor City, although that lead was 2-0. Still 2:41 to go in the second period here tonight, as Gaudette trying to get to the middle. Look towards the back door, bounces in the crease, and that one never crossed the line. Shipman had no idea where it was. He laid down and covered up. And the bouncing puck on that end again. In the first period, it was Babin who had one slip through him, and Vaughn Clouston saved the puck from crossing the goal line. And that time, another bouncer towards that net, and Richard Shipman had to do a snow angel to make sure the Rockers didn't get a quick answer to that power play goal by the Prowlers. Sent towards the net, but Schumacher turned it away. And now sent just out of the zone. So the Prowlers will have little pressure if they want to do a quick breakout. Schumacher over to Henning. He'll one touch it out to center ice. Sent right back in. Prowlers will try again. Schumacher going to skate it this time. Now Henning chips into the zone. Seffredini and Federle come together. Dustin Henning in deep, working on the puck. Two Rockers on him. And Seffredini takes the puck away. Dante Seffredini turns, looks, finds Elias Thompson. He tips it. Reeder with speed coming in. But good play by Henning, and Shipman knocked down Reeder as he got to the front. Here's Bartlett in front. Saved by Shipman! And a chop by Reeder towards Shipman. Henning didn't like that. He's got the gloves off. He's throwing punches. Dustin Henning coming to the aid of his goaltender, dragging Reeder, who is on his knees. And the referees will get everyone separated. It all started with the big hit by Richard Shipman as Reeder just got a little bit too close to the Prowlers' crease. Then Shipman made a huge save on Ross Bartlett, who found himself all alone in front. And then Reeder came in with an extra whack, and that sent the gloves off for Dustin Henning. And here's that fight that we saw yesterday. We've had two in the last few minutes of playing time, although it feels like a while ago when Weber and Brendan McKenzie fought. That was just about 5 minutes of game time ago, but feels like a lot longer. We've had a goal since then from Dakota Ulmer. And we're going to get four-on-four action, so they might not be getting the fighting majors unless we have the fighting majors plus. We'll get it all figured out in just a second for you. So the four for the Prowlers, Johnson, Minnie, Devaney, and Merritt. Rockers four, looks like it's going to be Bartlett, Seffredini, Everett Thompson, and they have yet to send out one more. Now they do. It's going to be Josh Colton. So we'll let you know the penalties when we know them. But for now, a face-off to Shipman's left. One back by Merritt. And Devaney slows things down in his own end. Joe Devaney scored the opening goal of the game yesterday in 4-on-4 action. That came just 4 seconds into the 4-on-4. Here's Merritt into the zone. Shoots, and a save by Babin. So they do reduce those fighting majors. No fighting majors to Henning and Reeder. Instead, it's a 2-minute rough to Dustin Henning and a 2-minute slash to Brad Reeder. Although Dustin Henning certainly got his money's worth if all he gets is 2 minutes for that. He had gloves off and punches thrown, and all he gets is 2 minutes. Clouston dropping it back to Rotondi as we hit the final minute of play in the second period. Clouston deflects it in on Shipman. He decides to cover up with 52.2 left on the clock. We'll be 4-on-4 for the rest of this period, and then the first 30 seconds of the third, if I did my math right. Minute 22 to go on the penalties and 52.2 seconds on the game clock, so you can check my math for me. Graham wins it forward, Jay rushing towards it. He's got Minnie joining him. Dalton Jay drops it back. Minnie tried to cut in, taken down, and no penalty called as Babin covers the puck. It looked like Minnie was tripped by Vaughn Clouston. Looked like he got his stick in Minnie's legs, but All's clean to the referees. Back to Makima. Up towards center ice. Johnson knocked it down. Gives to Minnie. Final 30 seconds as Johnson enters the zone. Pass behind Minnie. He had to go back for it. Clouston clears back to the Prowler's end. He's got a man going towards the net. Takes a shot instead off of Shipman's stick and out of play towards those suites on the south end. 18.8 to go in the second period. Contrato and Wynn out on the ice for the Rockers as Weber and McKenzie return to their respective benches to stick taps from their teammates. Comes back to Wynn at the point. Towards the net, that hit a Rocker in front. Contrato tries to put it back on, stopped by Shipman. Final 5 seconds on the clock. Jay just sends it over towards the Prowlers bench. And that will do it for 40 minutes of play here at McMorran Place. Prowlers lead the Motor City Rockers 3-1 on the strength of a power play goal from Dakota Ulmer and an even strength goal for Larry Vartiainen. Shots on goal 30-26 in favor of Port Huron. And we will be right back in just a few minutes, but first, make sure you secure your seats for our next home game tomorrow as the Prowlers take on the Motor City Rockers with puck drop at McMorran Place scheduled for 7.05 p.m. Tickets are available online at phprowlers.com/tickets or by calling the box office at 810-985-6166. That's online at phprowlers.com/tickets or by phone at 810-985-6166. You're watching Port Huron Prowlers Hockey on the Prowlers YouTube page. Chuck-a-puck just wrapped up here at McMoran Place as we are between the second and third periods with the Prowlers holding a 3-1 lead over the Motor City Rockers. Shots on goal in that second period. Prowlers doubling up the Rockers 16-8. Overall for the game, it's now 30-26 in favor of Port Huron. Prowlers dominated much of that period, and they got two goals to show for it. One from Larry Vartiainen on the rush, and what looked like an innocent shot beat Trevor Babin over the glove. And that gave the Prowlers their first lead of the game. And then Dakota Ulmer with the other goal for the Prowlers. Had the one-time chance in the slot on the power play that Babin stopped, but he got his own rebound, held it, took a look, and picked his corner, beating Babin over the blocker's side. And that gave the Prowlers their first power play goal of the season and a 3-1 lead. Couple of fights there in that second period. Well, one official fight between Austin Weber and Brendan McKenzie. That one was an official fight. The unofficial fight belonged to Dustin Henning and Brad Reeder with about a minute and a half left in that period. Richard Shipman took a shot at Brad Reeder as he was cruising past the crease. Made a huge save on Ross Bartlett, who found himself all alone below the hash marks. And then Reeder gave Shipman an extra slash. Henning took exception of that. Had the gloves off, was throwing punches, and all they gave was a two-minute roughing penalty to Dustin Henning and a two-minute slashing penalty to Brad Reeder. So that's how it all shook out. Both those men have 29 seconds left in the penalty box when we start the third period in just a few minutes. So that's your second period wrap-up. You're watching Port Huron Prowlers Hockey on the Prowlers YouTube page.
Adventures await you at the award-winning DoubleTree by Hilton Port Huron. Experience the breathtaking view of sailboats and freighters framed against the background of the impressive Bluewater Bridge, all from the comfort of your elegant guest room balcony. Planning a wedding? The DoubleTree by Hilton has the perfect setting to celebrate a marriage with its wonderful landscaping and beautiful reception area. So whether it's a romantic getaway, a family vacation, or a company outing, sweeten it with a view to remember at the DoubleTree by Hilton, Port Huron.
back here at McMorran Place, getting set for the third period of play between the Prowlers and the Rockers. Let's take you around the FPHL. One other game in action, just about to start the third period at Visions Veterans Memorial Arena in Binghamton. And it's the Black Bears giving a rude welcome to the FPHL, to the Elmira Mammoth. 8-1, the Binghamton Black Bears are blowing out Elmira right now. Two goals apiece for Jesse Anderson and Andre Vakalik, and three assists for Jake Schultz. And it's been a tough start to the franchise history so far for the Elmira Mammoth. Nowhere to go but up, I guess. Prowler spoiled the Motor City Rockers' first ever game yesterday and looking to make it two wins in a row, up 3-1 as we head into the third. 4-on-4 hockey for the next 29 seconds with a couple of players still in the penalty box. Henning and Reeder, the two, as we are underway. Minnie gets it over to Foley, dropped to Devaney, he hit the outside of the net. Johnson tried to put it back on, but it was blocked. Foley to Devaney behind the cage. Getting worked over by Contrado. Joe Devaney fights through it. Still with the puck. Here's Devaney. Tried for the wraparound. Couldn't complete it. Johnson working down from his point position, but Makima blocked his attempt to the net. Devaney comes back to keep it in as we're back to five aside. Wynn gets the first touch on it for the Rockers in this third period. Vartiainen kept the puck in just for a moment. Now it squirts back out to center. About a minute into this third period, Prowlers still holding on to a 3-1 lead as Jay deflected it down, but the Rockers coming back the other way. Sam Merritt lost his stick. Heinzel sends it all the way in on goal from his own end. Merritt touches back up, get the Prowlers onside. Colton directing traffic behind his own net. He'll come out and give over to Suffredini, cutting to the middle. Now getting through center, into the Prowlers' end. Parsons there to meet him. Suffredini tried to put it in front, poked away by Merritt, quickly towards the net. Suffredini tried to come out in front, and Richard Shipman robs Josh Colton. And for the second straight game, Josh Colton is robbed by the glove of a Prowlers goaltender. Suffredini almost had the empty net. He couldn't handle it. Then Shipman diving across to his left, able to get the glove on that Colton shot. Very similar, well, a little bit similar to Danik Rodriguez's save yesterday, where he went right to left to rob Colton on a backdoor pass. That was potential save of the year candidate yesterday. This one also a fantastic save, one for the highlight reel for Richard Shipman. Puck out of play in the Prowlers' end, so we'll have another face-off. Merritt, Graham, and Jay out there with Hansel and Parsons as the Rockers make changes, bring out Elias Thompson's line. Colton, wrist shot from the point, kicked aside by Shipman. Put back on, didn't get all the way through. Jay to Graham. He gets it just out, but turned it over to Giuliano. Now Hansel off the boards. Prowlers trying to get it in. Instead, back in their own end, Parsons takes it behind his own net. Being converged on by two Rockers, so he'll just send it off the glass and back out to center. Suffredini back out as these two teams play ping pong. Parsons tried to flip it out. McKenzie knocked it down just for a moment. Merritt got it out. Bartlett brought it right back in. Poked back out to center again. Here's Makima. Shot. Glove save. Richard Shipman. And he'll hold on. 17:26 to go in the third period. Faceoff taken by Federley. He'll exit the zone, rise a dump over top of Babin. kept in by Schumacher at the line. Here's Ulmer down low. Tried to look for a pass in front, sent it there. That went off of Federley, but Babin kept the post. Schumacher taken down. And a tripping penalty coming against Derek Makima, and the Prowlers will go back to the power play. Schumacher a bit slow to get up. Fell a bit hard there. Now heads back to the Prowler bench. Hunched over in a little bit of pain. And testing out that right leg a little bit. But it's another Prowlers power play. They scored on their last one. Dakota Ulmer with 1 second left on the man advantage. Beating Babin top corner. That is the last goal scored in this game. He's out there with Jay Graham, Vartiainen, and Johnson. Puck tangled up at the dot. Now Vartiainen sets things up. Jay over to Ulmer at the point. D to Johnson. Down low, Jay finds Vartiainen in the slot, but went through him. And all the way out to center. Johnson trying to dance in. Said Vartiainen enters the zone with the puck. Two Rockers on him, and it looks like Motor City's getting another penalty. It's a high sticking call, and we'll find out who the guilty party is. Prowler's going to have a 5-on-3 for a minute 29. It's Brad Reeder heading to the penalty box for the second time tonight. Rockers had a 5-on-3 yesterday, but a penalty shortened that. Prowler's hoping to take advantage here of the opportunity to extend the lead to 3. Ulmer to Johnson. Over to Vartiainen, the one-time blast. Stopped by Babin. He didn't know where it was. And now Johnson down low. Jay, quick shot. Squeezed by Babin as he tips over. And he's got it. With 16:14 to go in the third, a minute 9 to go on the Makima tripping penalty. Prowlers switch units, and Frank Schumacher back out on the ice, along with Federley, Foley, Devaney, and Merritt. Everett Thompson, Wynn, and Contrado. The trio for Motor City. Contrado has some space. Soft dump goes all the way down. Federley trying to turn back up with speed. So let's go Prowler's chance start here. Foley gets it to Merritt in the slot, save, and sent all the way out of play. And they're gonna get the delay of game penalty. Oh boy, penalties piling up for the Rockers as they're gonna have 3 in the box. Everett Thompson heading over, and a big opportunity for the Prowlers just became even bigger. Prowlers can't agree on which faceoff to take the draw. Merritt was pointing to one, Schumacher to the other. Sam Merritt wins that battle, and they'll go to the right of Babin. But first they have to wait for the clock to the officials running the clock. Now we're set to go. Devaney to Schumacher at the point. Now Federley. Down low, Devaney. Federley over to Schumacher. One-timer, he scores! Frank Schumacher, the one-time blast, and the Prowlers have a 4-1 lead. And because there were 3 Rockers in the box, it's still a 5-on-3 for the Prowlers even after the goal. They can really blow this one open if they want to. A 3-goal lead for Port Huron with 15:34 to go in the third period. Off the draw, deep in Prowler territory. And Federle trying to quickly move up again. Over to Schumacher. Frank Schumacher taking it himself in front. Big save, rebound, another from Babin. Puck still loose. Pushed back out towards the slot, and Schumacher keeps it in off the clearing attempt. Federle, down low, Devaney. Takes it himself. Babin with no stick makes the save. His goal stick is behind the net. Devaney walking out. Takes it himself and he scores! 3 power play goals in the game. 2 quick ones for the Prowlers. It's a 5-1 lead. And for Joe Devaney, his league-leading 3rd of the year. Right now, Babin on one knee talking to some defensemen. But he's going to stay in with 14:54 to go. Rockers looked like they were debating switching goaltenders, but decided against it. So the first goal on this power play, it's Frank Schumacher from Austin Federle at 4:26, and then exactly 40 seconds later, Joe Devaney, who also got an assist on that Schumacher goal, from Sam Merritt and Austin Federle. Prowlers blowing this one open in their home opener at McMoran Place. Now down to 5-on-4, still on the power play are the Port Huron Prowlers. But the 5-on-3 certainly doesn't need too much work. Firing on all cylinders. Johnson down to Vartiainen. Back to Johnson. Gets it back from Jay. Jay tried the quick pass across, couldn't get it. One hopped off the glass. And Bartlett sends it all the way in on Chipman. Shots now 39-30 in favor of Port Huron as Johnson dangles his way in, takes the shot, eaten up by a stick and off the glass. Ulmer couldn't handle the hot pass at the point. 32 seconds left on the 5-on-4 power play for Port Huron. Ulmer back to the point to Jay. Now Johnson finds Ulmer's rotated to the point, gives to Vartiainen. Down low, they score! What a pass by Larry Vartiainen! It's the 3rd power play goal in this period for the Port Huron Prowlers. They open up a 6-1 lead. You want to talk about a story for tonight's game, it's the power play for the Port Huron Prowlers. The last 4 goals of the game were Prowlers power play goals, starting with Ulmer in the 2nd period, Schumacher, Devaney, and now Jay. And we have a fight, Elias Thompson and Gino Mini going at it, and quickly Mini down, Thompson throws a punch. And they're quickly back to their feet. So Elias Thompson trying to get a spark going for his team. Now down 5 goals. These two fought yesterday behind the Prowlers net. That was in the first period yesterday. And they go at it again. Gino Mini fed Thompson punches yesterday. Looks like Thompson wanted to return the favor here today. And why not? His team down 5 goals. Parsons works it forward into the Motor City zone. Contrato versus to win. That pass cut off by Devaney. Foley trying to work it back down low towards Devaney. He rims it all the way around. Hansel first on it. Got through Foley. And now Clouston looking for the headband feed. Has Contrato into the zone. Contrato the backhand. Chipman eats it up and holds on. And some jeers coming from the Prowlers fans in the direction of Trevor Babin, who's faced 40 shots today after facing 37 yesterday from the Prowlers. Unlikely that we'll see him tomorrow for the third game of this series. Sent in, and Reeder bodied off by Hansel. Hansel and Reeder getting into it a little bit. Hansel gives him an extra shot. Play continues as Colton behind his own net. Suffredini given a shot by Federley. Colton turned over, and Federley couldn't hit the net from the slot on the turnaround try. Cardinal trying to force his way through. Federley took him down, and he knew it. He looks up to the rafters and heads straight to the penalty box. So the Rockers to the power play with 12:24 to go in the third period of a 6-1 game. Federley also had a scrap yesterday, like Gino Mini. Now they sit in the box together as the Prowlers look to kill this one off. Schumacher, as he was going down, got the puck out of the zone. Rockers rip it right back in. Makima to Gaudette in the corner. Bartlett let it go through to Suffredini. Backdoor pass, too hot to handle for Makima. He gets it back from Colton. Derek Makima walks up. Finds Colton to Suffredini. Just wrist one towards the net. Rebound, they score. Richard Shipman sent that rebound right to Derek Makima. And the Rockers get one back. It's a 6-2 game. Just a soft shot from the point from Dante Suffredini. And not quite as much towards the corner as Richard Shipman probably would have liked. That leads to the Rockers' second goal of the game. Merritt kicks it up to his stick, now sends it in Jay's direction. Couldn't get it all the way there. Matt Graham takes a big hit. And Jay deflects it into the Rockers' zone. Set up towards Johnson, and Parsons trying to get the red line and get it deep, and he does, to the far side corner. Jay and Rotondi come together, worked over to Parsons, walks in, shoots, save, rebound. Merritt couldn't get a stick on it. Jay battling with someone in the crease. He comes out behind the play. Meanwhile, Everett Thompson flying around the Prowlers' net. Thompson to Clouston. Shot blocked, and here comes Dalton Jay, all alone on a breakaway, saved by Babin. Now Ulmer flies in, keep it in the zone just momentarily, however. Parsons, long pass up to Ulmer, he's got some space, winds, fires over top of the net. Stayed in, though. off a weird bounce in that corner. Might have hit the referee. Ulmer and McKenzie battling for it. Austin Weber trying to come out with the puck, but McKenzie takes it from him. Set back deep towards Ulmer again. Dakota Ulmer tipped towards the net. And saved by Babin. He kicked that leg out. Now Federle all alone. Couldn't get the shot away. He lost the handle as he tried to go back to his forehand. Past the halfway point of this third period, and the Prowlers holding a 6-2 lead over the Motor City Rockers. We'll take a quick timeout. You're watching Port Huron Prowlers Hockey on the Prowlers YouTube page. Back here at McMorran Place, just set for puck drop to Richard Shipman's left in a 6-2 game for the Port Huron Prowlers. 9.5 minutes to go in the third period. Devaney collects the puck in the corner, puts it back behind the net. Larry Vartiainen, goal and assist for him so far tonight. Comes back out all the way into the Prowlers' end. Bartlett first on it, steps in, and Shipman got the pad down as Bartlett got away from Adam Heinzel. Devaney out to center, 2-on-1. This is Joe Devaney trying to feed it across. The sliding block there by Rotondi. Wind winds and fires as he enters the zone. Richard Shipman has it in the glove, and he'll hold on. Both teams make changes ahead of this face-off in the Prowlers' end. Shot comes to Henning, kicks it up to his stick, finds Graham, who deflects it deep into Rockers' territory. Colton out near side, heads to the far side. Now Reeder streaking in, and he scores! Brad Reeder got a step on the Prowlers' defense. And it's 2 straight for Motor City and a 3-goal game still with 8:32 to go in the third. So we'll see if the Prowlers try and slow things down here. It's 2 goals from Motor City has quieted the crowd, at least for now. Set back in to Prowlers territory. Dakota Ulmer first on it. Sent it in Weber's direction, but McKenzie got it instead. And it goes back down low. Ulmer flies in on Giuliano to make a big hit. Suffredini off the boards towards Bartlett. His pass across cut off by Johnson. He gives to Weber. Weber to the backhand and behind the Rockers' net. Caleb Williams muscled off the puck. Goes to the corner. Ulmer knocked down again. And took a shot while he was down. And McKenzie looks like he's going to the box. Dakota Ulmer slow to his feet. Referee pointing out who he wants to head to the penalty box. Rockers are the only one with a door open as Dakota Ulmer back up, back to the Prowlers bench. Caleb Williams also heading into the penalty box. We'll see what they got him for. So it's going to be 4-on-4 hockey. Federley and Devaney. Actually, Devaney decides he's going to stay out. This duo combined for a goal last time, yesterday when the two teams played 4-on-4. Devaney muscles his man off the puck, dancing with it behind the net. Johnson pinches in from his defense point spot, but couldn't keep it in. Shipman tries to play it towards Mini, battling with Bakima behind the net. And now Federley slows things down. McKenzie and Williams both get cross-checking penalties as Johnson softly touches it towards Babin. He'll cover up for a whistle. .714 to go in the third period. Prowlers send out Merritt and Vartiainen, along with Schumacher and Henning. Contrato, Bartlett out there for Motor City. Vartiainen trying to pull that out of the faceoff, couldn't. Reeder and Wynn the other two for the Rockers. Wynn directs traffic. Now gives to Contrato, up to Bartlett. All the way across to Reeder with speed, working on Henning. Dustin Henning poked it away from him, but up towards Shipman. Shipman got it, and now he has it in his glove. And play is paused. Merritt and Everett Thompson on the draw. Sam Merritt wins it cleanly. Schumacher up to Merritt. Off his stick, but he's got speed. Wynn pokes it away from him. And now the Rockers trying to move the other way. Thompson all the way across towards Cardinal. Tommy Cardinal gets around a check from Schumacher. Heading around the zone. Tried to drop pass, but the only player he dropped it to was Larry Vartiainen. 2-on-2 rush the other way. Dropped it off towards Merritt. I don't think that was intentional. Now the Rockers come back in. Long shot. Stopped and gathered in by Richard Shipman. 41st shot of the game for Motor City. Hainzel takes it off the draw behind his own net. Up to Jay, tried to give it back to Hainzel, but bit too much on it. It's the final 10 seconds, ticking off the penalty clocks for McKenzie and Williams. Gaudette had it poked off his stick by Parsons. Hainzel gets it out, one touch to Graham. Graham has Jay going to net, gets it to him, backhand, he couldn't get on goal. Williams, fresh out of the box, gets it deep. Jay turns back in to go to the forecheck. Instead, long pass out towards Bartlett. Now Caleb Williams collects just inside his own blue line, gets it to center. Bartlett sends Reeder into the zone. He's muscled off by Matt Graham. Now Bartlett tries a shot from a bad angle, sends it out in front towards Colton. Now Sapardini a shot, and Shipman has that. 5:08 to go in the third period. A little bit of talking here between Parsons and Reeder. And it looks like players go into the penalty boxes. At least one. Parsons going Still going after Reeder. And Brian Parsons, the only one in the box. Looks like the Rockers will be back up a man again. And now Reeder to the box as well. So looks like they'll even things up. Just have to decide if it's fives or fours. And it looks like it's going to be fours, with the penalties getting put up on the clock. Players on the ice seem to think it's five. So we'll see which one it is. Referees heading over to discuss with the off-ice officials. They have 2 minutes up on the board on both sides. And we're going to take a quick timeout as they figure this out. 5:08 to go in the third period. Prowlers doubling up the Rockers 6-3. You're watching Port Huron Prowlers Hockey on the Prowlers YouTube page. Back here at McMorran Place, after much discussion, we will play four-side hockey as Merritt wins the draw to begin that. Johnson tried to backhand it in Foley's direction, cut off by Suffredini. He's back into the Prowler's end. Steps around a hit, put it in front. That one lifted high over the net. Minnie takes it where it falls. And now Merritt chips it around his man, looking for Foley to the net, and a save by Babin. Back the other way, Bartlett one-on-one with Johnson, and Alex Johnson gets down to block that shot. Tried to set it in front, Foley knocked it down. Now he gets it up towards Merritt, but he couldn't handle the pass. Johnson takes the puck away, drops off for Merritt, back to Alex Johnson. The Rockers take it back. Makima stepping into the zone, tried to slip it across, and Shipman made the save, and the net comes off its moorings. We'll have a whistle and another meeting of the minds between the two clubs over on the far sidewall. Both teams set to drop the puck for the faceoff. We have an in-arena trivia segment going on right now during play as Johnson steps up over to Federley. He couldn't get to the net. One-on-one now. Makima trying to dance in. Pushed to the boards by Henning. Now Johnson finds himself some space. But he'll slow things down. He works it up towards Ulmer. Ulmer couldn't get a stick on it. Icing waved off. Dakota Ulmer knocked down behind the net. Jammed at the side of the net by Federley. Puck still there. And Babin had it for a second. Whistle goes. Net was coming off. And now a Prowler down where the net's supposed to be. Clouston shoved it away before it fell on anybody. And a gathering, I believe that's Dakota Ulmer. Down on his hands and knees. Training staff coming out for the Prowlers. It's Ulmer back to his feet. Dakota Dakota Ulmer bent over, but skating off under his own power. As the referees get the net back situated. Vartiainen and Weber out, along with Schumacher and Henning for the Prowlers. McKenzie, Contrato, Wynn, and Cardinal, the foursome for Motor City. One to the boards, and Contrato chips it out. Cardinal and Schumacher racing for it, and Frank Schumacher gets there first, working around his own net. Couldn't find Vartiainen. That's going to go all the way down for an icing. With 11 seconds to go on the penalties to Brad Reeder and Brian Parsons, both of them unsportsmanlike conduct penalties. 3:19 to go in the third period, a 6-3 Prowlers lead that was once 6-1, but looking a lot better now, over 5 game minutes since the Rockers last scored. Contrato curls back in his own end, over to Wynn. Wynn gets the red line, gets it deep, as Parsons and Reeder step out of the penalty box. Sent high off the glass in the Prowlers zone. Contrato keeps it in momentarily. Now Schumacher going to try this side. He gets it out. Rockers trying to regroup. It's Wynn. All the way up, deflected into Prowlers territory. Hainsel first on it. Had to play that bounce off the Zamboni door. He and Elias Thompson getting tangled up. They're having some extra words. Puck comes back towards Thompson. Hainsel makes sure it gets out of the Prowlers' end. 2:24 to go in the third. Giuliano and Hainsel come together. Sent towards the middle, but Weber has it. He'll lift it high out towards Rockers territory. Icing waved off. They say it was deflected. Play continues to move. Colton, his long pass up, only finds a Prowler stick. And Parsons stops behind his own net. Under two to play. Off the boards to Graham. Matt Graham tried to cut to the middle, but Everett Thompson took it away. Bartlett towards Gaudette. Graham broke up that offensive opportunity. Mini had to go back for it. Gaudette gets there first. Gaudette taken into the boards by Mini. He wrestles him down to the ice. Gino Mini lost his helmet. Bartlett trying to walk back into the slot. Couldn't get a shot away. Everett Thompson now with it behind the net. Tried the wraparound. Shipman got down to block that. Johnson looking for Jay. Jay with a step. He's in. Backhand. He scores. 2 for Dalton Jay in the game. And there's the cherry on top for the Port Huron Prowlers. It's 7-3. Babin smashes his stick and tosses it to the corner. He is frustrated. A 7-goal game for the Port Huron Prowlers. As Travis Ridgen is going to come in for the final minute 14. You hear the cheers from the crowd. A guy also known as Trav for Oilers, podcaster, YouTuber, and now in the FPHL. He spent the past few years over in Sweden playing in their third division. Last year was 8-4 with a .433 goals against average and an .884 save percentage, again in Sweden's third division with Varberg HK. Faceoff won back into Rockers territory as we approach the final minute of play in the third period of the Prowlers' home opener. Reeder steps in, took the shot, got blocked. Caleb Williams gloves it out. Cardinal all the way around. Shipman plays it towards Federley. Vartiainen gets it just out. Might not have gotten out, but Haynes will make sure it does this time. Sends it over to Caleb Williams, who deflects it into the zone. Gaudette reverses back in the direction of Clouston. Henning trying to break up a rush, dives to poke it back to Rocker Ice with 18 seconds left on the clock. An impressive offensive explosion for the Port Huron Prowlers as they use four power play goals, three of them in the third period, to defeat the Motor City Rockers by a final score of 7-3 in their home opener here at McMorran Place. So Prowlers starting the season 2-0. A big game from the offense, and Richard Shipman very good in goal as well. 43 saves on 46 shots against. He had to make some good ones, especially when this game was close heading into the third period. Alex Johnson finishing with three assists. Dalton Jay, two goals and one assist. Jay down to five goals away from 200 in his FPHL career as the Prowlers salute the fans after a big win over their in-state rivals, the Motor City Rockers. That's going to do it for me. Thank you so much for tuning in to Port Huron Prowlers Hockey. We're back tomorrow as the Prowlers take on the Rockers for the third game in 3 days in this series, as the Prowlers and Rockers battle again here at McMorran Place. 7:05 is the puck drop. Thanks for tuning in, and have a great rest of your evening.